Hello everyone, welcome to Unify Study. Today we are going to discuss a very important topic of white box testing, that is statement coverage, branch coverage and path coverage. It is coming in the exam, and here in this video I will show you how to determine the statement coverage, what is statement coverage, what is branch coverage, what is path coverage and what are the difference between them. After finishing this video, your all doubt will be clear and you will be able to solve the previous year's question. Yes, the previous year's question from UGC NET. I am taking the question from UGC NET. I am covering the question from UGC NET because nowadays questions are coming in UGC NET. And this part is very, very, come to the main point, that is what is statement coverage and what is branch coverage. What is coverage? First, you have to understand that what is coverage and why it is important. Actually, the coverage means it is doing in testing. Okay, so in the testing, in the time of testing, what you have to do? First of all, if your code, I am giving you a code, simple code, that is int a comma b, and if a greater than b, then print a is large. Okay, a is large, and if or else, sorry, this should be else b is large, right? So this is your code. So from this code, if I want, if I tell you that how you will test, मतलब आपको टेस्ट करना है दिस कोड इज रनिंग करेक्टली और नॉट. तो आप कैसे टेस्ट करोगे? फर्स्ट यू विल टेक ए इक्वल्स टू 3 एंड बी इक्वल्स टू 5. मीन्स हेयर ए इज ग्रेटर देन बी इज ग्रेटर देन 3, राइट? सो इफ यू पास द वैल्यू दैट इज ए इक्वल्स टू 3 एंड बी इक्वल्स टू 5, देन हेयर ए इक्वल्स टू 3 एंड बी इक्वल्स टू 5. सो ए ग्रेटर देन 5, इज इट ट्रू? नो. Here it is coming to the else part, so it will print that b is greater, right? And now another test case, if you write here a equals to, maybe I am writing here a equals to 5 and b equals to 3. I am taking b 3 5, you can take here 6 2, anything you can take. But what is our motive? Our motive is I will take one time a is greater and another time a is less, right? So that I can test my code. So now what it will show? It will show here that a is greater, right? A is 5, so a greater than b, yes it is correct, so it will print a is greater, right? So this, from this two test case it is confirmed. So this is the test case, means we are doing the testing of this coding part, we are doing the testing. So that is the testing, and that's why we have to understand that how we have to cover, means you have to cover everything. What you have to cover? You have to cover all the statement in the statement coverage, you have to cover all the branch in the branch coverage, and there is another point, that is path. You have to cover all the path in the path coverage. So you have to understand what are the statement, what are the branch and what are the path, right? From here you can see easily that here we have write the two test cases. From this two test case we are checking this program is doing correctly. Now if there you take another test case, that a equals to 3 and b equals to 3. Now in this test case, tell me what it will show. Tell me please what it will show. If a 3, means here it will show here that a equals to 3 and it is b equals to also 3, right? So if a greater than b, no, it is not, because it is false, it is not a greater than b. So it will come to the else part and it will give you that b is greater. But is it correct? No. So your actually logically your program is wrong, because when a equals to b, then it is also showing that b is greater, right? But b is not greater here, so must you have to write that no, b is not greater. Actually there should be another else part. What what you have to write the program correctly. If you want to write the program correctly, then you have to do like that. I am taking another sheet, that will be better to understand the topic. That is, my program will be, if A greater than B, then print A is greater, right? And now else part mein, what it is the possibility? The possibility is A less than B also, or another possibility is A equals to B also. So here also there will be else if A less than B, right? So if A greater than B, if it is not, so A less than B, right? So if A less than B, then print, or you can write here another way, that is another way I am telling, that else if B greater than A, you can write any way, A less than B or B greater than A, anything you can write. So here print, here B is greater, right? And another thing, what the else part of this if. So here we have to write the else, and here we have to write that print A and B is equal, right? Because if A greater than B is false, and if A less than B is false, then definitely A and B are equal. So now for this, what you have to write, how many test cases you have to write? You have to write here A and B, I am taking the test cases, that is 3, 5, first test case, another test case is 5, 3, and another test case is 3, 3. So from these 3 test cases, we can cover everything. So what we are covering, that is how many branches are there. See me, tell me how many branches. What are the branches? Branches means when there is if else condition. When there is the if else condition, that is telling the branches, means you are dividing. You are dividing it. How? You are checking the condition, and if it is true, means there is a true part, and if it is false, then there is the false part. So for every if condition, there is 2 branches, right? One branch is true and another branch is false. So that is the branch coverage, means we have to cover all the branch in our test cases. See here, from these 3 test cases, we are covering all the branches. From this 3 greater than 3 and 5, from this A and 3 and 5, we are covering these branches, that is A less than B, right? And from this 5 and 3, we are covering these branches, that is A greater than B. And from this 3 and 3, we are covering this else part. Is it branch? Is it branch here? How many branches are there? Tell me. Here there are 2 condition. This is 1 condition. How many condition are there? There is 2 condition. And how many branches are there? From these 2 condition, for every condition, there is 2 branches are creating, means if it is true, then it is coming here. But if it is false, then there is another if condition. So if it is false, there is another if condition, then this condition, there is if condition. So from this condition, there is true and false, another 2 branches there, true and false. So from this true, it is coming here that B is greater, and from this false part, again this is coming that else part, that is A equals to B, right? So here it is showing A greater than B, here it is showing B greater than A, and here it is showing A equals to B. So in that way, you have to write down the test cases to cover all the branches. And what are the statement? Statement are this statement. These are the statements. So it will be more clear from the flow graph. Come to here now. Now overview is clear. I think why it is important and what is the purpose of the statement coverage, branch coverage and path coverage, right? So what is the statement? Statement means a statement is an entity in the programming language which is typically the smallest individual unit of the execution, right? So smallest individual unit means every line, you can think that every line where you are writing any statement, that is the statement. and the object is showing the executable statements within the program. What statement you are executing within the program, that are the statement, right? Now, a statement coverage is the percentage executable describe at least that, therefore, to achieve 100% statement coverage means in your program maybe there are 100 statements. So, you have to cover all the statement, right? So, if you can cover all the statement, maybe there are 50 statements. So, if you cover the 50 statement with your test cases, mean how many test cases required to cover all the statement, then it is the 100% statement coverage. So, 100% statement coverage, we have to make sure that every statement in the code executed at least once. Means if there is 50 statement, then at least once this statement should be executed, right? Now, statement coverage does not ensure coverage of all functionality, definitely, because maybe you have write statement, how you are counting, what you are write, but maybe there is some statement like that, is there is an if condition, and if this is true, then there is the condition print something, but there is no else condition. So, if the else condition is missing, that does not mean ki the functionality is missing, right? So, aap kya kar rahe ho ki if ke against mein jo print statement hai, jo anything, kuch bhi statement hai, you are covering this statement, but you are not covering the else part. So, you are not covering the total functionality, right? Just like here we are not covering the total functionality, because why? Because if there is a if condition like matlab jahan pe a ho raha tha ki a equals to b, if a equals to b, then we are not checking this, so it is not checking the full functionality, right? Now come to the branch coverage. So what are the branch are the decision means where you are taking the decision, that is the condition are the decision. So, a program point of which are the control flow has two or more alternative routes. When two or more alternative routes are coming? When there is the condition. What are the condition? Condition may be if, condition may be while condition is also a condition, like condition may be anything. So, these are the condition when easily you can think when there are more than one way to go, right? It is the condition, and from this condition there is more than one way to go, right? That is the decision. Now, 100% decision coverage implies both 100% branch coverage and 100% statement coverage. Remember this, if you are covering 100% decision means what are the decision you are taking, if you are covering all the decision, matlab jitna bhi decision hai aapke program mein, if you are covering everything, then definitely you are covering all the branches, because all the decision you are covering means there are the branches. So, if this decision is covering, means you are covering the true or false, both branches you are covering, and if you are covering the both branches, then from these branches, if true, then there should be a statement, and if false, there should be a statement, means you are covering this statement also. So, in that way, if you are covering 100% decision, means jitna bhi decision hai aap cover kar rahe ho aapke test case mein, then definitely you are covering all the branches and all the statement, right? Now you have to know another topic, that is there any difference between the branch coverage and decision coverage. So this is little bit tricky, you have to understand that. No, sometimes somehow we are thinking that branch coverage and decision coverage are same, but it is not exactly same, because branch coverage is closely related to the decision coverage. It is okay, at the 100% coverage they have mostly given same result. Because why? Because when you are covering the 100% decision, then you are covering the 100% branches also, but vice versa is not true. Why the vice versa not true? Because decision coverage measure the coverage of conditional branches only, means where there is conditional branches, this is the decision, right? Here this is the decision, this is the decision branch, and here the conditional branches are this is yes and this is no. So these two are the conditional branches. You can see these two are the conditional branches. And what are the unconditional branches? This is the unconditional branch here, because from here I am coming to print. I am coming to print from this statement. This is a statement. When this is yes, then this is the statement, and after this statement means we are calculating the value here, A equals to A star 3. After calculating, we are printing. We are printing. We are coming to this print. So this is a unconditional branch, right? This part is the unconditional branch, but in the decision coverage, we are trying to cover till this part. We are trying to cover only yes and no, but we are not bothered about this part, right? That's why you can see branch coverage measure the coverage of both conditional and unconditional branches. Matlab, if you are doing branch coverage, then total branch it will cover. This is the branch and this is the branch, total branch it will cover. But in the decision coverage, it will not cover. It will cover only the conditional branch. Decision coverage measure the coverage of conditional branch only. This it will cover only this two branch. It will not cover this branch. Okay, so it is clear to you, I think. Decision coverage will cover only the conditional branch, but branch coverage will cover conditional and unconditional both. Okay, so this is the difference between conditional and unconditional. Now come to the path coverage. So what are the path means? How many independent path are there? I have already take an class for the there is a video that is cyclomatic complexity. It is directly related to the cyclomatic complexity. Please check the video of cyclomatic complexity. Here there I have discussed how many independent paths are there, how and what is the complexity. This path coverage is directly related to the cyclomatic complexity. Why? Because in the path coverage, we are trying to cover all the independent path. Now, what are the independent path means? What are the independent path means? If this is your starting, means if this is your main, means main, int main from this main, and if this is your exit from the program, then there may be some condition. There are some condition is there. There is true, false, anything, and after that it is joining here, it is joining here, finally it is coming to this, finally it is coming to this execute. So how many paths are there? Path means from the starting to end, how many independent way to go. Independent way are, this is a way, right? If you go in this way, so this is the way. You can go in this way, so this is the way. You can go in this way, so this is the way. You can go in this way. So how many paths are there? You can see here there are actually one, this path, and another path is this, two, and another path is three, another path is four. So actually there are four path. Actually there are four independent path, because for every branches we are creating two path, right? That is the our motive to cover all the path, right? So from starting to end, that is the path of the independent path we have to cover in the path coverage, and in that way you have to write the test cases. How many test cases you have to write to cover all the path? That is our motive. Now come here, how to calculate the statement, branch and decision coverage and path coverage. Draw the flow graph. You have to draw the flow graph. So how to draw the flow graph? I already told in the cyclomatic complexity. Please check the cyclomatic complexity, that how to cover the branches, how to write down the branches. So every time you have to draw the flow graph here, and node represent the entries, means there are some nodes, that is the circle. Circle are the nodes, and exits, decision, and each statement, right? So and edges represent the non-branching and branching link between, means edges means these are the edges from this node to this node, these are the edges, right? Now come to this program. This is a small program. Here you can see this is the example, that print read P and read Q. So read P and read Q, it is a first statement. So this is my first statement. Now after that, if p plus q greater than 100. So here I am checking that p plus q greater than 100. This is the condition. Means condition you have to write like a diamond. So this is the condition symbol. So in that condition, after that, if this is true, then I am printing it is large. So if it is yes, so I am printing this is large. Now end if means it is coming to here. It is coming end if, and there is, you can see for this if there is no else condition, but we have to draw this else condition. Although there is no else condition given, you have not write the else condition, but it does not means ki for this if there will be no else, right? It does not means this. So there should be a no, means if it is not true, then it should be false. So you have to consider this branch also. There should be a no part, and from this no part you will merge here, that is end if, right? So after this end if, again we are checking that if p greater than 10, p greater than 50, yes, we are checking this condition if p greater than 50. Now we are printing this is large. Yes, p is large here. Now again you can see for this if there is no condition like else. We are not writing the condition else, but you have to consider the else part, because if this condition is false, then it is coming to there. So false you have to consider every time. So in this false you have to come here, and finally you will end here. So remember this, everywhere when you are drawing the flow graph, don't try to draw only the given statement. Means here the statement is given, but you have to consider the other branches also, because if there is some condition, then there should be two branches, one is true, another is false, right? Always you have to consider true and false, both branches, otherwise your flow graph will be wrong. Now come to the coverage, how to cover everything. So first cover the statement. So how many statements are there? Easily, what are the statement? This is the statement, these are the statement, okay? Means how many statement was there in the program? These are the statement. This is my first statement, this is my second statement, this is my third statement, this is first, this is second, this is third, and this is fourth, and this is fifth, right? So these are the statement where you have write the boxes. The boxes are the statement, right? Now you have to cover all the statement. Our motive is I have to cover all the statement. See, in this branch it is blank, there is no statement. In this branch there is no statement, because in the program the else part was not considered. That's why there is no statement. So we are not bothered about these branches, we are bothered about only this statement. How many statement are there? Now tell me, to cover all the statement, what are the test cases you have to write? It is checking that p q, read p and q, and after that p plus q greater than 100. It is not 10, it was 100. So what you have to do, you can take that is p equals to maybe I am taking 50 and q equals to 60. So then p plus q will be 110, right? So here if you check p plus q greater than 100, yes, it will come yes, right? So it will come to the yes part, and it will print the large, right? Now it is printing the large. Now after that it is checking p greater than 50. If p greater than 50, here check that p not greater than 50, right? So you cannot cover with this test case. Now can you write a test case like that? P equals to 60 and q equals to maybe 60 is there, no problem. So that will be 120, right? You can check here 50 also. Just you have to do that should be greater than 100. So now you can check here, if the p is 60, then it will be yes, and it will print this. And after that, finally p greater than 50, yes, p greater than 50, because value of p is 60, so it is true. Now it will print this value. So you can see from this test cases, that is p equals to 60 and q equals to 60, from this test cases you can cover all the statement. I am covering this statement here, read p and q, yes. I am covering this next statement, that p plus q greater than 100, yes. Now I am covering this statement also, because it is yes, so it will print, this is large. Now finally it is coming to this condition, that p greater than 50, yes, p greater than 50. Finally it will print, that is p is large, yes, p is large. And finally it is coming to the ending. So from this one test case, from this one test case, you can cover all the statements, means this is the 100% statement coverage, right? So how many statement coverage is there? Statement cover karne ke liye how many test case you have to write? Only one test case you have to write. Within this one test case you can cover all the statement. So that's why the statement coverage is 1, right? It is clear to you? Means you have to minimize the test case. Our motive is how I can minimize my test case. So as only one test case is required, and what is the test case? That is my test case. From this test case I can cover all the statements, so statement coverage is 1 here, right? Now come to the point of branch coverage. So how to cover the branch coverage? Now I am changing the color of my pen, so for better understanding I am taking the blue color. Now tell me, can you cover the branches from this test case? All the branches can you cover? Here you can see the branches is we are leaving here, that is no part. This no part is a branch, means if it is false, we are not considering the false part here, we are not considering the false part here, right? So to consider this false part here, you have to write another some test cases you should write. What test case you should write to cover this branch? Because we have covered this left part, right? We have covered this left part, that is true part, and from here all the branches is covering, but right part, sorry, it is the right part. And from this left part we are not covering, so we have to cover this left part. How we can cover this left part? Means you have to take a value like p and q should be, where p plus q should be less than 100, because we have to do it false, right? Our motive is to do it false. False karna hai mujhe. So how to do it false? You can take any value, that is maybe 30, and another thing you have to remember, that you have to do it false also, because you have to cover this. So from one test case our first motive is, from one test case we have to cover the both branches, but we are not completing. So we have to take p less than 50, right? So you can take p equals to 30 and q equals to 40. So if p equals to 30 and q equals to 40, means p plus q equals to 70. So from here p plus q equals to greater than 100, no. So it will come to this branch, no. Now come to this condition, p greater than 50, no, p not greater than 50, so it will come to this branch. So this is false, right? So p, now here from this condition, that p equals to 30 and q equals to 40, means we are covering this branch also, this false branch also. So what is the branch? That is a1 1a 2b. So this is my 1a 2b, means this was 1 and this was a. I am coming here for more clear. Yes, 1a means this is a, then b, this is 2b. 1 I am taking here, 1a 2b, and finally I am coming to the e, then e, and then 4f. So 4f, right? So I am covering this here. So how many test cases are required here? 2 test cases are required here. What are the test cases? First test case was p equals to 60 and q equals to 60. From this test case I am covering this right side, this right side, that is 1a 2c 3d, everything. And from this next test case, that is p equals to 30 and q equals to 40, I am covering this, right? So I think now it is clear to you. So if it is not, if now it is fill everything from my writing, So please back the video and check the clear image, where there was clear image. So now try to understand what are the test cases and why the here one test case is required and why two test cases is required. How we are doing that branch coverage is 2 and statement coverage is 1 here, right? Now come to the path coverage. Now how many paths are there? From this 2 test case, so what are the test cases we have already take? We have take first test case was P equals to 60 and Q equals to 60, I think, right? Yes, Q equals to 60. So from this first test case, we have covered already this path, right? This path is already covered, right? And another test case was that is P equals to 30 and Q equals to 40. So I am changing the color for better understanding. So another test case was P equals to 30 and Q equals to 40. So from this test case I am covering this path, right? I am covering this path. Now anything left? There is any other path what we are leaving? Right, there is some path we are leaving. What path we are leaving? Think once, just pause the video and think once, what are the path? There may be a possibility that if P plus Q greater than not greater than 100, that is okay. Now here, if there may be the possibility that P greater than 50, yes, so there is the path like this. This can be a path, right or not? This can be a path. So for this also you have to write. What you can write? You can write a test case like that. P equals to 60. I am taking P equals to 60 and Q equals to 20. So here you can see P plus Q equals to 80. So this condition will be false because it was 100. It is printing mistake. Please note down. This is 100. So P plus Q greater than 100, right? Less than 100. So it will come to here. Now here it will check P greater than 50. No, P greater than 50. Yes, P greater than 50 because it is 60. Now it will cover this. Now any other you are missing? Yes, another you are missing. Think it. Pause the video and think what you are missing. Something you are missing. I can say something you are missing. So what you are missing? See, another thing is if P plus Q greater than 100, that is the possibility. Yes, greater than 100. Now come here and here is the possibility like that key P less than 50, right? So now this will come to this branch, right? Now this will come to this branch. So how many colors are there? From this color you can see. So I have to write another test cases like that where P plus Q greater than 100 but P less than 50. But I can say like that P equals to 40 and Q equals to maybe I can take 70, right? If you take like that, then P plus Q will be, that is 110, right? Sorry, there was 110 was there, right? Yes, 110 was there. So from here you can see how many paths are there. Yes, here I was. So 110, from this 110 how many paths are there, you can say. So what are the paths? How many paths? First path is this, second path is this, third path is this, fourth path. How many color are there? 4 path. So these are the 4 path. You can see 1A, 2B, E, 4F and 1A, 2B, E, 4G, 1A. These are the 4 path. You can easily understand the 4 path and how many test cases are required. This is my first test case. This is my second test case. This is my third test case and this is my fourth test case. So 4 test cases are required to cover all the paths. So path coverage is here 4, right? So now I think it is clear to you how to cover the path. This is the path coverage. 4 is my path coverage. And what are the branch coverage? 2 is my branch coverage. And what are the statement coverage? 1 is my statement coverage. Means you can cover all the statement using one test case. Minimum test case. What are the minimum test case you can write to cover the statement? One from one test case we can cover. That was the one statement. What was the one statement? This statement, right? P60 and Q60. Now here we have taken this two test cases. This is my first test case and this is my second test case. From this two test case we can cover all the branches. And come to the path coverage, from this 4 test case, this is 1 2 3 4 test case, we can cover all the path. Now try to solve it. That can you cover, can you write down any other test cases, can you minimize? If you can, please let me know in the comment section that path coverage can be solved with using 2 or 3, means less than 4. Can you cover this? No, you can't cover. Try it for your better understanding and let me know in the comment section. Now, coverage. What are the coverage in percentage? Sometimes the question is coming in the coverage is percentage, means wow, means think that from this one, if they give this first cover, first test case, from this test case how many statement coverage is there, or I am taking this test case. So from this test case how many statement you can cover? All statement we can cover, so statement coverage will be 100%. But if I tell you that path coverage will be what? 50%, because from this test case you can cover only the right branches, but you cannot cover the left branches. That's why here the branch coverage will be 50% and statement coverage will be the 100%. And from this path, if I ask you that path coverage, so path coverage, what is the path coverage? So only one path you can cover from this 4 path. There is 4 path, so 4 paths say you can cover only one path. So what is the percentage? That is 25%, because 100% you, for covering the all the path you have to write 4 test cases. 4 paths are there, you are covering only one path. So 1 by 4 into 100, that is 25%, right? So here I am showing this, that statement coverage from this, if you are covering this statement, that is 60 60, in the test case P equals to 60 and Q equals to 60, using this test cases how many coverage was there? 100%. But you are covering, if you are covering the statement like this, 1A means 1A, then 2B, and then E, I am covering E, then 4F, right? So if the test case is like that, key P equals to maybe I am taking 40 and Q equals to 60. So if you are taking this test case, so using this test case you cannot cover this statement. This statement is left, because when you are coming here then it is fine. Yes, P greater than 50, then it is coming here. But BE. So here I am taking Q equals to 40. So 40 40 80, it is 80, so it is not fulfilled 100, so it is coming to the false statement. Now 4E, now come to this statement, so E, so here it is 50, no, not greater than 50, so it is coming to here. So I am covering this statement here. So how many statement you are covering? How many statement, total statement was there? 1 2 3 4 and 5. So 5 statement was there. And how many statement you are covering? So first statement you are covering 1, second statement 2, third statement 3. 3 statement you are covering, but you are not covering this statement. You are not covering this statement and not covering this statement. So 2 statement you are not covering. So 3 by 5 into 100, right? So it is 60%. So from this test case, that is P equals to 40 and Q equals to 40, you can cover only 60% of the statement. there was 5 statement and you were covering only 3 statements, so 60% is the statement coverage, right? Now come to the next branch coverage. So same test cases I am taking, same because 1A to B here, 1A to B, E, 4F, so this is the path 1A to B, means 1A to B, then E, then 4F, I am covering this. So test case is was P equals to 40 and Q equals to 40. So from this test case, how many branches you can cover? So I am covering this branch. How many other branch was? What is the other branch? This was the other branch. This branch I am leaving. I am covering this branch, but I am leaving this branch. So what is the branch coverage? Easily there was 2 branch. I am covering 1 branch. So that is 100. So 1 by 2, that is 100. That is 50%. So 50% is the branch coverage here from this test case, that is P equals to 40 and Q equals to 40. And now come to the path coverage. So same test case, from this P equals to 40 and Q equals to 40, from this test case I can cover only how many paths I am covering, that is 1A to B, then E, then 4F. So total path, how many paths were there? 4 paths were there, was there, and to only one path I am covering. So 1 by 4 into 100, that is 25% I am covering, right? So their path coverage is 24. So from this test case, that is P equals to 40 and Q equals to 40, path coverage is 25%, branch coverage is 50%, and statement coverage is 60%, right? So now you can solve any type of question from the statement coverage, branch coverage and path coverage, I think, right? Now try to solve this question and let me know if it is correct or not. Pause the video, try to solve it, and then I will show you the answer. So the question was, software testing following statement not correct. It is there, not correct. How many of you tell me that not show, did not watch the not? So many students are there who are ignoring. So please try to read the question. There was a not, right? Not correct. So which is not correct? Only the minimal test said that achieve 100% path coverage will also achieve 100% statement coverage, right? So it is not correct, right? What it is not correct? Now tell me, is it correct or not? It is correct, definitely. Why? Because when we are covering the 100% path coverage, then definitely all the paths we are covering, just now we can say all the paths we are covering means definitely all the statement will cover, right? Now come to this Q, that minimal test case achieve 100% path coverage will generally detect more fault than which achieve the 100% statement coverage, definitely, because path coverage 100% for the covering 100% path, you have to take what are the minimal test case, think it. In the path coverage, what are the minimal test case, and in the statement coverage, what are the minimal test case? And it is asking that a minimal test set that achieve 100% path coverage will generally detect more fault that achieve the 100% statement coverage. Why? Why? Go to the percentage. Tell me, in the percentage, when we are covering here statement coverage here, from this, what are the statement coverage? That was 60% statement coverage is there. And here for the path coverage, tell me, what are the path coverage? There was 25% path coverage was there. And it is asking the minimal test set to achieve, how many minimal test set is required to achieve 100% path coverage will generally detect more fault than one achieve 100% statement coverage. So statement coverage karne ke liye we are taking only one test case. From this one test case we can cover all the statement, but can we cover all the path? No, right? Now come to a minimal test set that achieve 100% statement coverage will generally detect more fault than one achieve 100% branch coverage. Is it correct or not? Tell me that if you are achieving 100% statement coverage, right? Now, one that achieve 100% branch coverage. Branch cover, agar if you are covering all the branches, then can is there any fault? Ho sakte ke nahi? Nahi ho sakte, right? So that's why only the R is only the not correct. It is not correct, right? What it is not correct? Why it is not correct? I think it is clear to you. If it is not clear, then please let me know. Please read down all the statement carefully and it will be more clear to you. It was asking which is not correct, which is not correct. This both are correct. Only the option, only the R is not correct, because a minimal test set that achieve 100% statement coverage. So statement coverage ke liye, what are the test case? Test case was 100% test case was P equals to 60 and Q equals to 40. From this test case, now it is telling that coverage will generally detect more fault than one that achieve 100% branch coverage. Is it true? So branch coverage करने के लिए कितना statement, कितना लिखना चाहिए था आपको test cases? How many test cases you are writing? You are writing another test case, that is P equals to 40 and Q equals to 40, right? Because for the left side, right? So definitely it is not correct, right? So R is the answer. Now try to solve this question. It is your home task, it is your task. Try to solve it. You can easily solve it, and after that I will show you the answer. Here it is asking the exhaustive test. That is a new topic, that is exhaustive test. Exhaustive test is nothing. You have to check all the combination, how many input is required, how many combination is there. It is taking all the combination, that is only exhaustive. Means I am showing you what is exhaustive. Means if there is 26, I can see here that 26 letter is there, and I am giving you the idea for not for 26, Boolean value. There are Boolean value. How many variables are there? A, B, C and D, right? Four values are there. So for four variables are there. For this four variable, how many value is possible? All are the Boolean. So Boolean means either it will be true or false, or 0, 1 or 0. So for this, for every variable, there is two combinations. So four variable is there. So how many combination is possible? Tell me how many combination is possible. You know already that combination, how to do the combination with this. So definitely there will be 16 combination is possible, right? You can know like 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 1. From this our digital logic you already know. So 16 combination is possible, right? So it was, I am telling you the answer for the exhaustive test case, that is the 16. Now try to solve this two cases, that is test full statement coverage and full branch coverage. Pause the video here, try to draw the flow graph and try to solve it, right? Now this is the answer. From this answer it will be more clear to you. This is the flow graph. And from this flow graph, easily it is clear to you that to achieve the full statement coverage, how to achieve, that is 3 minimum test cases is required. Here 5 minimum test cases is required. Why? Because for the branch, what are the branches? This is the branches, this is the branches, and this is the branches. And where it was asking statement. So these are the statement, here are the statement, but in these branches there was no statement. That's why we are not bothered about the statement coverage for these branches. So we are covering only these three, but for the branch coverage we have to cover this remaining part. That's why the branch coverage here is 5, right? So statement coverage is 3 and branch coverage is 5. clearly. And exhaustive test, actually there was 26 letter. If you take the 26 letter password, means 3 character password, just read it, it will be clear to you. And another question is this. This is another question from UGC NET December 2017. Try to solve this. How many exhaustive test case? Same question. Here is Boolean, same question is there. So this is the answer. Now this is the another question here also, that Boolean value, these are the Boolean value and these are the int. Try to solve it. And it is asking that full branch coverage and achieve full statement coverage. So draw the flow graph, pause the video, try to solve it. Let me know if you can solve or not. Now I am showing you the answer. So this is the answer, this is the flow graph, and from this flow graph you can easily do the answer. The answer is 3 and 4. Why the answer is 3 and 4? It was asking that minimum test cases had to achieve how many statement coverage was there. Statement, what are the statement? These are the statement. How many test cases are required to cover? These are the statement, right? This is a statement and this is the statement. So to cover all the statement, how many test case? 3 test case easily. You can do it easily, 3 test case, right? And for the branch, and another question was that full branch coverage, to cover all the branches, how many extra branches? Some extra branches is there, that is no part extra branch, there is no statement, so that's why we are not covering, but this have to cover, this is the branch left, that's why the answer is 3 and 4, right? I think this video is helpful for you all. So please subscribe.